Hello everybody, in this video I'm going to show you how to fix every single error for Black Ops 6 and Warzone that I've found so far, and I've included solutions that haven't been found in my other videos. Well, at this point I've created so many videos about Black Ops 6 and Warzone errors that I should have a PhD in this, but I've compiled a complete list that seems to work for everybody, so try to follow along for every step. Okay, so the first step is to adjust the game files, locate the installation folder, so go to Xbox app, and what you want to do is disable compression. So go to Call of Duty, right click on the game, click on manage, click on files, click on browse. Here you will see the Call of Duty app and you'll see content. So you want to right click on this folder, go to properties. Here you want to go to advanced, and then you want to make sure that compressed contents to save disk space is unchecked, and then click apply, then okay. Now this doesn't work because it compresses the cache files, and for some reason that makes it, well, not work properly. And you can do this with Steam or however you've installed it as well, as long as you find the folder. Okay, solution two, reinstall the game. So I'm sure you know how to reinstall the game, but you want to, right click on it and click on install, or on Steam it's very similar. But once you've uninstalled it, you want to reinstall only the HQ file. So basically only the base game. It should be about 11 gigabytes, right? Then once you've done that, you want to go through, so right here, the base game, and then run it and see if it works. Then after the HQ file installation, open the card HQ hub, and then select the additional components such as multiplayer or campaign, and install these one at a time. For some reason, this does seem to fix this for a lot of people, so make sure that you've done that. Okay, so solution number three, you want to remove conflicting software. So you want to basically remove Face ID, Vanguard anti-cheat, malware bytes, and other anti-cheat or other antivirus software. So of course, go to settings, go to apps, install the apps, and then find those things. You might not even know that if they're installed or not. I don't have Valorant installed. But Vanguard anti-cheat will be installed by default if you installed Valorant, for example. And these seem to mess with the anti-cheat software of COD. So you want to remove these and then restart your computer and then restart the game and see if it works. Okay, let's move on to solution number four. You want to modify registry entries. How do you do that? Go to run. Type in regedit or registry editor, right click on this, click run as administrator. This will come up, and then you want to navigate to the Call of Duty folder. So I'll put this in the video description, it's right here. And here, you'll see image path, and under data, you'll see Call of Duty content ran grid.sys. Okay. And then you want to check that this image path points to the correct location. So this should be C, Xbox games, Call of Duty content ran grid.sys. This will be a little bit different, of course, if you installed it on a different folder. But basically, this is a common issue if you've installed it on Steam, for example, then uninstall the game, but this will still basically stay in the registry edit and it will point at the wrong location, and this will cause errors. So you can either change it, you can modify it so it points to the right location. So how do you find this? Again, go here, manage files, browse, Call of Duty content. rangrid.sys will be in this content folder. And then follow the copy the file path, I should say, and paste it in here. Alternatively, there's another way you can do it. So you can simply delete this. Yes, delete it. And this will cause the game to have an error if you start it, unless you do the following step. So you go to settings, apps, installed apps, Call of Duty. Here, go to advanced options, go to repair and reset. So basically what this will do is it will recreate all the registry edited files, including the one we just deleted, and it will point to the correct location. You want to try this step anyway to see if this fixes it. Okay, so now that should fix that. Let's move on to solution number 5. Okay, so the next step is to go into your documents folder on Windows. Scroll down, and then you'll see Call of Duty folder here. You want to delete this. This will not impact your game very much, but you might have to basically redo some settings within the game. But this does seem to help a lot of people. So try that. The next thing you want to try is go into check the event log. So basically every error has a event connected to it and has a different solution. So how do you do that? Go to event viewer in Windows. So type in event viewer. Navigate to Windows logs and under system. So when you try to launch the game and an error comes up, look at it here. So the most common errors are 0x2, which is caused by a conflicting anti-cheat software or other conflicting antivirus software, or 0x3, which is often related to registry issues, which I solved earlier in this video. But there are other errors as well. I have made a bunch of other videos covering each error separately. Okay. So the next step after you've done this is you want to unlink devices in the Microsoft Store. So here's the URL here. So you want to go into the Microsoft Store, or you can just go to Microsoft.com, log in with your Microsoft account, and you want to check which devices are logged in. So keep in mind, you can only have 10 devices linked to your account. And then after that, basically it won't let you log into Xbox Game Pass. And this includes Xbox games as well. Now, a lot of people have more devices than they think connected. If you reinstalled Windows a bunch of times, for example, or if you've had some, maybe logged in with your Xbox a bunch of times, it does link a bunch of other devices. So you might want to check this to see if this is basically okay. The next thing you want to do is run the game as an administrator. So how do you do that? So go back to Xbox, go to manage, go to files, go to browse, go to Call of Duty content. You want to find the Call of Duty executable. And this will be a little bit different in Steam, or if you've downloaded through other folders. But basically, yeah, you want to find the executable, right-click, properties, compatibility, run this program as administrator, hit apply. By the way, once you're here, you might want to try disabling full screen optimizations. This does seem to glitch the game for some people. Hit apply, hit okay, or you can just right-click and say run as administrator. By the way, people saying they don't have cod.exe, well, they just have cod. That's because by default, you don't see file name extensions, but you can go to view, show file name extensions. If I turn it off, yeah, you don't see it anymore. Okay, and again, this will be very similar if you're doing this on if you're doing this on Steam. Now, you can also do this with the desktop icon. It's very similar, but you just you just right click on it and say run as administrator, and see if that works. The next solution you want to try is use a clean boot. So basically, go to search, type in msconfig. I'm sorry, run. Type in msconfig. And go to the services tab. Click on hide all Microsoft services. And then click disable all. And then restart your PC and launch the game. And see if this works. If the game does work, then try basically re-enabling them one by one to identify where the problem is. Okay. Next step, let's go into PowerShell. This is so much fun. So go to search, go to PowerShell, right click, say run as administrator, say yes. I'll put this in the video description again. Copy the first one, hit enter. Copy the second one, hit enter. This will come up, gaming services, click install. Then after you've done that, it will ask you to reboot your Xbox game app. And then after you've rebooted your Xbox game app, this will reinstall gaming services into your Xbox Game Pass app, which is causing a lot of problems for a lot of different people. After you've done this, left click on your profile, click on support. And then you'll see the gaming services repair tool. So click on this, and this will repair the gaming services, basically all the games you have installed. And let's do that to see if it works. Okay, and the final solution, or second to final solution, is to download this bat file I've created. I put this on my Google Drive. So here it is, you download it. It's a bat file, so download anyway. And you run it. So you download unverified file. Please don't worry, it's not a virus. So once you run the file, you just double click it. Say more info, run anyway. So after you've downloaded it, right click on this, say run as administrator, hit yes. It's going to ask you for the file location. So you go to your Xbox game app, right click on the game, hit manage, hit files, hit browse, go to Call of Duty, go to content, copy and paste this file path here. Take this and paste it into here. And then it will hopefully successfully complete. And then hit enter, close down Xbox Game Pass, restart it. And that should fix the issue. So I've also created a text file of this. Some people are apprehensive with the computer saying it's a virus, which is understandable. So I created a text file version of this file. I'll put it here. And that it looks basically like this. So what you do is you just download it. And then rename the file name from txt to .bat if you want to. But basically, I just did this to get around the antivirus and so you can look at it and see that it is certainly not a virus. By the way, I've created a Windows 10 and Windows 11 version of this. So whatever version of Windows you're running, you want to make sure that it matches. And now for the final solution, if nothing else has worked, you may want to roll back to Windows 10 if you're running on a Windows 11. I know it's very annoying, but this is a solution that seems to work for a lot of people. Basically, the game is not really well optimized for Windows 11 at the moment. And that is it. If this video helped you, leave the video a like. If it didn't help you, leave the video a comment and I will do my best to get back to you.